in a cottage by the forest, a mother and her little girl. Since she always wore a red cape and hood, the little girl was called Little Red Riding Hood. She was a pleasant girl, as fond of her grandmother as she was of spending time outdoors with her animal friends. One day in springtime, Little Red Riding Hood's grandmother became ill, so the mother made her a pie. Little Red Riding Hood's mother hummed as she rolled the dough and cut the apples, and soon the pie was ready. The mother carefully packed the pie into a basket for grandmother, who lived in the cottage at the other side of the doors. Woods. Bring this to grandmother. It will make her feel better, said Little Red Riding Hood's mother, handing her the basket, and she will be happy to see you. Keep to the path, my dear, so you won't get lost, and don't talk to strangers. Tell grandmother I will visit her tomorrow. Little Red Riding Hood was pleased to be entrusted with such an important task. She waved to her mother as she set off on her way. Oh. The sun shone brightly, and it seemed that even the flowers waved as they moved in the warm spring breeze. As she walked deeper into the forest, the trees' branches overhead blocked out much of the sunlight. The path is like a delightful cave, thought the girl, and she began to skip. Because Little Red Riding Hood was so kind and gentle, the forest animals liked her. Before long, the girl noticed that her animal friends were coming with her. The birds flitted from the tree to bush, and the squirrels raced along the branches. Perhaps they thought she was too little to make such a long journey alone. It's a lovely day for a trip through the woods, said Little Red Riding Hood, and in a language that only the girl could understand. The animals agreed. What is that sound? Asked Little Red Riding Hood to ask herself. She could hear heavy footsteps. Suddenly, a wood appeared. Wolf appeared. Goodness, you startled me, said Little Red Riding Hood. She didn't know enough about wolves to be frightened of this one. Did I? Replied the wolf, thinking what a tasty treat the girl had made. I'm just out having my morning stroll. The girl has forgotten her mother's warning not to speak to strangers. I'm on my way to grandmother's cottage at the other edge of the forest, she said. The wolf nodded, wondering how he could delay her and get to the cottage first. He could have both her and her grandmother for lunch. I'll be on my way now. Wait. Suddenly, the crafty wolf had an idea. I think a bouquet of wildflowers would cheer her. The old lady, he said, ready. What a grand idea, replied Little Red Riding Hood. I will pick her some flowers right away. How happy she'll be. I'll be on my way now, said the wolf. I'm sure we'll meet again. I hope so, said the girl. Wolf stunned into the woods, but as soon as he was out of sight, he dashed away, running as fast as he could to her grandmother's cottage. This is my lucky day, he thought. Not one, but two meals for my hungry tummy. He just knew where the cottage was, so he wasted no time heading toward it, leaping over logs and dogging trees. Little Red Riding Hood ran to find her animal friends. Guess what, she asked them. I met the kindest, the nicest fellow, and he suggested I bring Granny a bouquet. Isn't that a fine idea? I know where the prettiest flowers are, exclaimed one of the squirrels, pointing to the wood. Little Red Riding Hood also had forgotten her mother's warning not to stray off the path. She and her animals wandered into the woods until they came into a clearing. Colorful wildflowers grew all around the sunny clearing. Little Red Riding Hood stopped to pick them, and in no time she gathered an armload. What pretty flowers, she said to herself. Then she picked up her basket and made her way back to the path. I have to thank Mr. Wolf for this advice. The squirrels looked at each other. Mr. Wolf, said one of them with alarm. They scurried after the girl. In the meantime, the wolf had arrived, panting from his long run. At grandmother's cottage, he waited until he caught his breath. Then he knocked at the door. "Who is it?" came Grandmother's voice. "It's the Red Riding Hood," answered the wolf, mimicking the girl's voice as best as he could. "The door's unlocked. Come in, my dear," replied the grandmother. The hungry wolf opened the door and glanced about the room. Then he bounded to her grandmother's bed. Before she knew what was happening, he had gobbled her up in one bite. The squirrels and mice arrived at the window, so just in time to see the wolf's misdeed. They looked at each other with a laugh. "The Red Riding Hood will be next on his menu," exclaimed the squirrel. "We must get help," squeaked the mice. The animals raced off into the forest. The wolf waddled out of the kitchen. He drew the curtain close. He found one of Grandmother's nightgowns and nightcaps and slipped these on. He pulled the cap over his big ears and got to bed and pulled the covers up around his chin. The wolf was almost asleep, for he was feeling full, when he heard a knock at the door. Doing his best to imitate Grandmother's voice, he called it. "Who is it?" "It's Little Red Riding Hood," came the girl's voice. "Come right in, dear," replied the wolf. Little Red Riding Hood unlatched the door and stepped into the cottage. "My, it's dark in here, Granny," she said. "I've brought you a basket of food for Mother and some flowers to make you feel better." She tried to sound very cheery, but she found very uneasy. She approached the bed. "Goodness, you don't look all like yourself," said Little Red Riding Hood. "You must be very sick." Then the mice had found a family of Little Red Riding Hood's rabbit friends in the woods. "Come quick," exclaimed the mouse. "The wolf has eaten Little Red Riding Hood's grandmother, and next you eat her. Hurry, we must save her." Mice, squirrels, and bunnies scurried and hopped as fast as they could toward Grandmother's cottage. Back at the cottage, Little Red Riding Hood was peering and staring at the figure in Grandmother's bed. "My grandmother," she said with a smile, "what big eyes you have." "All the better to see with you," said my dear, quoth the wolf. Just then his ears popped out from under the nutcap. "Ah, grandmother, what big ears you have," said the girl. "All the better to hear you with," replied the man. "Grandmother, what big teeth you have." "All the better to eat you with," cried the wolf, leaping out of bed. The wolf swallowed Red Riding Hood in one gulp, feeling very full indeed. He walked slowly out of college into the barn. He was looking for a place to take a long nap. The hay looked inviting. As he nosed out, he felt so pleased with himself that he made a little song about how clever the wolf was. The wolf was so sleepy that he took no notice of the mice and squirrels chattering in the barn loft. If he had understood what they were saying, he could have taken note of them, for they were busy planning his downfall. "The spade is ready," called one of the squirrels. "The rope is ready," called another. "Patience," said one of the mice. "Wait until he's just at the right spot." The animals held their breath as the wood angled into rain, and then, bonk, the squirrels let go of the spade handle and landed squarely on the wolf's head. "Bullseye," shouted one of the squirrels. The wolf lay on the ground in a daze. Quickly, a mouse tied the rope to the wolf's tail. Throwing the rope after a rafter, he ran it through a pulley. The animals began hoisting the wolf into the air. It took strength of every bunny, mouse, and squirrel. When the wolf was fully spent into the air by its tail, Grandmother Little Red Riding Hood thumbed out of its open mouth and landed on the soft hay. The animals cheered when they saw the two were unharmed, and a bunny explained how they have performed the rescue. Little Red Riding Hood was terribly shaken, but grateful to her animal friends. "I shall never trust a wolf again," exclaimed the girl. "And when Mother tells me not to keep the path and not to speak to strangers, I will do just that." Grandmother laughed the pest herself. Then invited everyone to have some pie. The wolf, in the meantime, had drained himself up and was slinking into the forest. The wolf was hungry again, but even worse, he was feeling quite sheepish. Wherever he wandered from then on, the forest animals remembered his naughty exploit. "Foolish wolf, the birds would call." Then they would titter as the wolf passed by, pretending not to notice. And as for Little Red Riding Hood, she lost a mole carry to her mother after her narrow escape. And every morning she scattered breadcrumbs and seeds for the animals who had saved her life.